Hi, I'm going to show you how to design a taser, but under one condition. By no means is this safe to be used on any living creature. This is just a demonstration of a design, and if those sparks touch anybody, I won't like you anymore. A taser is basically a device that generates very high voltages above 10,000 volts and is used to temporarily disable a person, and sometimes it kills a person. It's super high voltage, what did you expect? You don't just chase somebody continuously. It is meant as a short shock to temporarily disable a person. If you like to use a taser or any other sort of excessive force and get away with it too, then just join the police force. You get a proper training, a license, certified tools, and a decent salary. Otherwise, refrain from hurting anything. To create a high voltage from a low voltage source, you need a transformer. A transformer is of the inductor family, and its output to input voltage ratio is proportional to the secondary to primary winding number of turns. Also, it only works with AC signal. So if the secondary to primary turn ratio is 100, if I apply 10 volt AC at the input, I'll have 1000 volt AC at the output. Now for my transformer, I use this one that's generally used in a car. It's called the car ignition coil and is responsible to generate sparks across the spark plugs that ignite the fuel in the cylinder. This specific transformer has this wire arrangement and it has a secondary to primary ratio of around 60. So the output voltage will be 60 times the input. Here I connected a power cable to the primary to connect it to the wall plug. With 120 volts AC on the input, I should have close to 7000 volts AC on the output, which I'll measure. I'll plug it in. A quick research shows that different transformers work best at different frequencies. This transformer is obviously not made for the 60 Hz city power frequency. But wait! The primary winding is an inductor. Imagine it is this spring. If I force a voltage across it, it will charge and discharge based on what I dictate across it. But if I charge it and then let go, then it will discharge to a very high voltage, way beyond 100 volts, and that on the secondary means more than 10,000 volts. So for example, if I connect my 12 volt supply here to the primary and charge it and then disconnect it, the voltage of the primary should jump up, creating a huge voltage on the secondary here that should create a spark. Let's try it out. There is nothing. Is there actually a voltage? Well, my theory was right. Obviously, there is high voltage on the secondary, but the problem is that high voltage pulse period is so short it can't create an arc. But there is a way to extend that period.
If I add a capacitor on the primary and then connect the supply, it charges both the inductor and the capacitor. And when the supply disconnects, the inductor and capacitor start oscillating, pouring charges into each other. So the primary voltage will look like this, which decays over time.
I put this capacitor bank together and put it across the primary. Let's pulse the primary now. Look at that, I have sparks. Notice that I have sparks when I disconnect the supply. Now I need to make the sparks continuous, so they go jzzz. For that, I designed a simple circuit.
If I press the button here, the relay here will switch back and forth, and that will charge the primary of the transformer, and the sparks will fly out of the secondary. You can read more about it in my website, electroboom.com.
I've made my simple circuit here, and I attach it to the primary, and I'm using my 12 volt drill battery as the source. Let's try it out. Wow, this is wild. You can see how far it's a strange pain. It's as if somebody is stabbing your finger, but the blade, it doesn't stop there. It keeps going through your veins until it reaches your heart. I love it. I made it look more like a taser by gluing these nails to it. Let's look at it spark now. This gap is quite wide. Let me measure it for you. Well, you know, metal is generally conductive and electrons always find the easiest path to travel. So I would never touch any high voltage with a 100-mile long metal pole. Let's look at the spark some more. These sparks are so strong, they can set a piece of paper on fire. See? Always be careful when you set things on fire at home.